5 years after VJ Day, the people of Britain come to grips once more with world aggression. A cabinet meeting on rearmament brings Mr. Strachey to number 10 with army estimates. Lord Alexander is followed by Mr. Bevan, worried about threatened economies. Here is Mr. Shinwell, Defence Minister. For Ernest Bevin, Foreign Secretary, the world situation means the destruction of great hopes. Decision to recall Parliament 5 weeks earlier fails to satisfy Mr. Churchill and Mr. Eden, who arrive to argue in favour of an even earlier recall. These are tragic days. The people of Britain would have preferred to talk peace. Now they must make sure they are not unprepared for war. Target for the RAF is 198,000 by April 1951. And recruits, especially for the volunteer reserves, are mounting in numbers. Nor do the women lag behind the men. It's a proud service both go to fill. At Filton Airfield, secrets of Britain's latest jet fighters are shown to 25 air cadets on a visit from America. This is symptomatic of the close liaison which now exists between the two great democracies. At Fort Dix, New Jersey, they have a quick way with recruits. With a million men to train by the year's end, the United States Army teaches fast. Battle training with live ammunition is resumed. Recruits are put through a realistic course, which familiarizes them with the noise and danger of battle. With machine gun bullets whistling over their heads, they soon learn how to make the best use of cover. In Ottawa, queues form in answer to Canada's call for 5,000 volunteers. 200 join in the first hour, and the list is closed within 8 days. These reinforcements will mean strength in distant Korea, behind which the weak may shelter. This scene of refugees moving back is typical. But too often, they are used as a cloak for the North Koreans' most successful tactic, infiltration. These following pictures highlight the danger of the sneak attack behind the lines. Small wonder that the few on the ground bless the strength of the many in the sky. Cannon guns blast red troops moving up for the attack on Taegu. Operating from Okinawa, 700 miles distant, Super Forts step up their attacks to over 800 tons of bombs per raid. Deaf ears were turned when we pleaded for peace. Now bombs must take the place of words until the aggressors withdraw.